Jose Morales scored the only goal as Levante defeated Villarreal. A late penalty from captain Jose Morales gave Levante a 10-0 win over Villarreal in the La Liga return at Ciutat de Valencia. The Segunda Division champions went close at the end of the first half when a header from Alex Alegria hit the underside of the crossbar. Villarreal almost went ahead in stoppage time when Alvaro Gonzalez saw his effort from a corner saved. On 65 minutes, Levante defender Kima stabbed the ball just wide from close range and it looked like a disappointing night for the home side against the neighbours from 64 kilometres up the coast. Morales saw his rising shot saved by Villarreal keeper Andres Fernandez before finally making the breakthrough with just 2 minutes left. The Levante skipper weaved into to the left side of the penalty area before being clipped by Antonio Rukavina. Morales picked himself up to coolly dispatch the resulting spot kick low into to the bottom right corner, thus getting Levante's start to life back in the top flight off to a good start. Monday's late kickoff saw Eibar win 10 at Malaga with a goal for Brazil forward Charles against his old club. The visitors thought they had raced into an early lead through the summer signing after just 3 minutes, but the celebrations were cut short as the referee had spotted a handball. Malaga went close when Venezuela forward Wanbi saw his shot flash just past a post. Charles, who left Malaga in the summer after 2 seasons, then fired straight at goalkeeper Roberto Jimenez from inside the six-yard box. Just before the hour, though, the Brazilian did find the net when he headed across from defender Jose Angel into to the far corner. Malaga almost grabbed an equaliser when Borja Baston, on loan from Swansea, saw his long-range effort saved by Marco Dimitrovic. At the other end, Eibar defender Ivan Alejo headed over before, with 15 minutes left, Japan midfield attack Ashi Inui forced a good stop from the Malaga keeper. Page 2. The guys respond to your tweets about Manchester City, possible Liverpool purchases and Real Madrid's dominance. The ESPN FC crew evaluates Sergio Ramos' behaviour after he tied La Liga's all-time record with his 18th red card. Jose Morales scored the only goal as Levante defeated Villarreal. A late penalty from captain Jose Morales gave Levante a 10-0 win over Villarreal in the La Liga return at Ciutat de Valencia. The Segunda Division champions went close at the end of the first half when a header from Alex Alegria hit the underside of the crossbar. Villarreal almost went ahead in stoppage time when Alvaro Gonzalez saw his effort from a corner saved. On 65 minutes, Levante defender Kima stabbed the ball just wide from close range and it looked like a disappointing night for the home. Gab McCarthy reacts to Neymar's criticism of Barcelona's board and explains why President Josep Bartomeu is under pressure. The FC panel discuss Neymar's criticism of the Barcelona board and Barca's win over Real Betis in the La Liga opener. Nice general manager Julian Fournier says no talks have taken place with Barcelona over the transfer of midfielder Jean-Michel Seri. Multiple reports in Spain on Sunday said that Barca expected to finalize a €40 million deal for the Ivory Coast international in the coming days, but Fournier says he expects Seri to stay at the Allianz Riviera. "We haven't negotiated with Barca, nor do I know of any negotiations lined up in the next few days," Fournier told Sport. "They're just rumors." Neymar's brace and 2 assists in his PSG home debut earned him the top spot in this week's power rankings. Page 3. Real Madrid opened the La Liga campaign in comfortable fashion, winning 30 away to Deportivo, despite Sergio Ramos' late red card. Few observers were shocked when Sergio Ramos became the most sent-off player in La Liga history late in Real Madrid's 30 La Liga opening weekend win at Deportivo La Coruña on Sunday evening. But to look back through the record books shows surprisingly how the Bernabeu outfit have really been too troubled by his subsequent absences through suspension. Ramos was quite lucky just to be booked midway through the second half at Riazor after an entanglement with Depor centre-back Fabian Schär that saw him raise a hand into the Switzerland international's face. It meant that sympathy was limited when he was a bit unfortunate to pick up a second yellow during added time after jumping with his arm raised in an aerial challenge with Depor substitute Borja Val. In total, Ramos now has 23 red cards in 526 Madrid games, a club record ahead of former Blancos tough guys Juanito and Fernando Hierro. Sunday's was also the 18th La Liga sending-off for the 31-year-old, an all-time record along with his former Sevilla teammate Pablo Alfaro and ex-Zaragoza defender Xavi Aguado. He has also been ordered from the pitch 3 times in the Champions League and 2 times in the Copa del Rey. In addition, Ramos has 147 yellow cards, putting him 4th on the all-time Primera Division list headed by current Getafe defender Alberto Lopo, who has 14 reds too. Lopo was actually playing when Ramos got his first career red soon after he joined Madrid as a teenager in 2005. Those who feel that Ramos' reputation in Spain precedes him, and therefore that trouble follows him around rather than vice versa, can point to the 143-cap international having never been sent off when representing his country. This apparent anomaly was put to him in the Riaz or mixed zone on Sunday evening, and he repeated claims he has made before that he feels he gets a raw deal from Spanish domestic officials. "Not everybody likes that we are doing well, but we sleep fine every night," said Ramos. "There were some controversial moments. I don't think decisions are made in advance, but sometimes people should pay more attention. Maybe referees allow more in the Champions League and in internationals. Maybe we should look a bit more at the English model, where they let play go more." Few felt sympathy for Ramos' record-setting dismissal on Sunday night, though Real barely blinked in his absence. Whether Ramos would really benefit if Spain's disciplinary committees did start to review TV evidence of games is a moot point. What we can say, however, is that Madrid have often tried everything to lessen the punishments handed out when he is red-carded. The club have often appealed his dismissals, even managing to free him completely from any sanction on 3 different occasions. Images were successfully used to prove that a handball penalty against Villarreal had been incorrectly awarded in what was current Blanco's coach Zinedine Zidane's last game as a player at the Bernabeu in May 2006. Villarreal were again the opponent in 2012, when Madrid's legal team found an error in the referee's report, which was filed after a particularly chaotic match that saw then Madrid boss Jose Mourinho also sent to the sidelines. Such arguments also seem to have ensured that Ramos has missed remarkably few games through suspensions following his many sendings off. Quite fantastically, his previous 22 red cards have brought suspensions covering a total of just 24 matches. Of these, Madrid have won 18, lost 3 and drawn 3. They did not miss the captain too badly. There has been just 1 game ban, after Ramos got an extra punishment for insulting the referee on his way from the pitch following an elbow on former Liverpool striker Florence Namapong-Ol in a Liga clash with Recreativo Huelva in 2008. Ramos' longest suspension was 5 games back in January 2013, when he reacted angrily to being shown a 2nd yellow for a dangerous challenge on Celta's Augusto Fernandez with his team already 40 ahead and calling the match officials shameless, having spent the whole game fing us. Usually though, Ramos has missed just 1 game for his dismissals, even when getting straight red cards for dangerous player challenges from behind. Barcelona's Lionel Messi has been on the receiving end a couple of times, most recently in last April's 43 Clásico defeat at the Bernabeu. The aggressor again got the bare minimum punishment on that occasion, and Madrid won 6-2 at Deportivo the following week. It is also striking how often Ramos returns from suspension just in time to make a big impact. In early 2013, he was sent off 2 times in 2 months, and on both occasions, his first games back were Clásico wins against Barca, with the defender even scoring the opener in a 3-1 victory at the Camp Nou. On Sunday evening, Madrid's Director of Institutional Relations, Emilio Butragueño, suggested that Madrid would be appealing again this time around, and it is quite possible that the 2nd yellow card will get rescinded and there will be no suspension again. But the success of the latest appeal might depend on how generous Spain's disciplinary authorities are feeling given last week's furore over Cristiano Ronaldo's 5-game ban, including 4 extra for pushing the referee in the Spanish Supercopa. Generally, the record shows perhaps why Ramos has not changed his ways at all despite so many reckless red cards over the years. He may often get sent from the pitch, but neither he nor his team usually suffer too badly. Dermot Corrigan is a Madrid-based football writer who covers La Liga and the Spain national team for ESPN FC. Follow him on Twitter @DermotCorrigan.